Hello, beautiful blockchain people. That's me again at CryptoSpine. This is my next cryptocurrency market overview. So let's start. Let's have a look at the prices of the major cryptocurrencies according to the site of CoinGecko. And as we see, the market has recorded a small price increase for the last 24 hours. So most of the major cryptocurrencies have been trading in the green zone. But if we have a look at their price charts for the last 7 days, we see that they have been moving sideways or the market has been consolidating. And today is Monday, that's why today we will analyze the price chart of Bitcoin. So its current price is $66,000 per one digital coin. So today we will analyze the price chart of Bitcoin in the different time frames. Of course, we will start from the monthly time frame, but initially let me remove the volumes. This is the monthly chart. We are very familiar with the monthly chart. The current price here is $65,788. First of all, let me remind you that last month for October, we had a solid bullish candlestick that covered the bodies of the previous ones. It has surpassed also the previous local high. Also, it has the highest closing price. So we used to analyze even the linear chart, so this is how it looks like. We have a sequence of ascending local lows and ascending local highs, so we mark this as a solid bullish signal. Compared to the previous all-time high from 2017, we see that the current price chart is completely different, so we have a bullish signal here. Also, this is the current candlestick for the current month. We're in the middle of the month. We have a small bullish candlestick. It has a local high above the previous ones and its local low is above the previous ones. So to some extent, it confirms the bullish signal. Of course, it is not a very solid, let's say, bullish signal, but on top of the previous solid bullish candlestick, this is additional bullish signal. Now let's switch to the weekly chart. Okay, this is the weekly chart. This is a solid price increase that took place earlier this year, followed by a consolidation. Then the price experienced a decline. Then the price rebounded and resumed the uptrend. Here we had a bullish engulfing followed by a three white soldiers candlestick formation. After that, the price consolidated. And now it seems that the price is resuming the uptrend because last week we had a bullish candlestick, so this one that has of course a small bullish body, but it's above the bodies of these ones, and also it has a local high above the previous ones and a local low above the previous one. So this is a bullish signal, so I would say that this is a bullish signal indicating that probably we are at the very beginning of the next, let's say, up wave or up increase. And now we will switch to the daily chart, and let me remind you that here we measured the first wave followed by a correction, let's say. Then we added the same height, so this is actually the second wave, so we're here. Here we didn't have this, let's say, correction. Instead, we had this consolidation, and now it seems that the price is starting to resume the uptrend, and probably we will add the next wave that has the same height. And I talk about it in my previous analysis here. I just wanted to remind you. We will have a look at this at the 4-hour chart as well, but for now, let me remove these elements, and because we're in the daily time frame, let me add the three key moving averages. So the first one is the moving average for the period of 30 days. Then we need the moving average for the periods of 90 days and 1 year. So this is the first one. 30 days or 1 month. Then we have the moving average for 90 days or 3 months or 1 quarter. And last but not least is for the period of 1 year or 360 days. So these are these three key moving averages. All three key moving averages are heading upwards. So this is a bullish signal. Also, we have a bullish distribution of the moving averages. At the top is the 30-day moving average, in the middle is the 90-day moving average, and at the bottom is the one-year moving averages. So, also, it's obvious that the price has been consolidating here at the 30-day moving average. And once again, if it receives enough supports to rebound, then it will resume the uptrend. And this is what I wanted to say relating to these tricky moving averages. So the daily chart is bullish as well. Now let me remove these moving averages and check the 4-hour chart. Okay, this is the 4-hour chart. Here, once again, let me remind you, we had a price increase followed by a correction. And we had this, as I used to say, bullish flag. The price exited the flag and resumed the uptrend. So here we added the same wave, or I mean the same height. Then here, let me change a little bit the angle. So here we had some kind of correction, a very small correction. So that was another bullish flag. The price has exited this bullish flag again. So we know that these bullish flags are common trend continuation patterns, and it seems that the price is now resuming the uptrend. That's why we will add the next wave. And as I used to say before, according to the height of these waves, the next target is $83, $85, or $90, $90,000 per one digital coin, depending how we add this height. Also, if we switch to the shorter time frame, to the 1-hour chart, it's obvious that here the price is starting to draw an uptrend or ascending channel. Of course, we can play a little bit with the trajectory of this ascending channel, but it's obvious that we have a sequence, that the price has exited the bullish flag. It's obvious. And it's obvious that if we switch to a linear chart, we have a sequence now of ascending local lows and ascending local highs. So definitely in the 1-hour chart, we have an uptrend. So fellas, that's it for today. I would like to put it in a nutshell. We have bullish signals in the major time frames, at least in my view, according to the technical analysis. Please share your point of view as a comment below. Of course, I wish you a very wonderful day, good and productive week ahead, good luck in the financial markets, and I hope to see you in the next one. It was me again at CryptoSpot.